The next speakers that we have tonight is moving on from speech number 8, which we have just listened to project number 9. Now, project number 9, the objective of project number 9 is to persuade into power. So this is the first step towards giving a persuasive speech. And the objective of this speech is to persuade listeners to adopt your viewpoint or ideas or to take some action. Appeal to the audience's interest. Use logic and emotion to support your position. Avoid using those, of course. Jack Ng, as I mentioned just now, is our VPPR. He's outgoing and enjoys the roles of the. I'm also undergraduate, actually. And enjoy most of the outdoor activities. His favorite TV channel is Animal Planet. Toastmaster Jack Ng is going to share with us tonight the three R's. The three R's. Toastmaster Jack Ng.
Ladies and gentlemen, the three R's is not Rolex, it's not Rolls Royce, it's not Ronaldo, it's reduce, recycle. Can you repeat with me? Reduce, recycle. That's right. According to a census done by the United Nations, in year 1987, the world population was 5 billion. In year 2012, it went over 7 billion. It's predicted that in year 2050, the population will reach 10.9 billion. Quick news, isn't it? Unfortunately, is our natural resources doesn't go proportionally with our population. It goes reversely. Our natural resources would get depleted by then, and we will have more natural disaster. So today I'm here to try to convince you we can change a little bit of our life so we can make the world a greener place to live. You do not have to jeopardize your life in order to save the world. For example, you don't cut your regular drinking of water from 8 glasses to 2 glasses. And you do not eat raw food every day because you want to save electricity or save some gas. There are some little things you can change to be part of the conserving to make our earth greener. Let me start with reduce. Are any of you not affected by the recent Klang Valley water rationing? I guess all of you are affected since you know okay. So most of the people get affected, right? Let me ask you, when you brush your teeth, do you turn the water tap on? Do you? No? No answer?
Yeah.
Okay. If you do not know that, the water flows about 12 to 18 liters per minute when you turn on your tap. It depends on the tap that you're using. And do you know how much is 12 to 8 liter? This is 5.5 liter. You're using two bottles of this one. Don't you think it's a lot of water that you're using just to brush your teeth? Normally, dentists recommend 2 minutes so that your teeth will get shiny and bright. So 2 times 12, 24 liters. That's a lot of water for this one. I did an experiment by myself. Actually, you only need this much of water to brush your teeth. If you don't believe it, you bring a bottle, 500 milliliter, you fill up the water, and then you try to brush your teeth. I guarantee you will come out the same effect. And you you not only reduce your water bill, you also help to conserve and make the world greener. The next one I will talk about is reuse. Well, most of you are working employee, correct, in the office or maybe boss. Sometimes you print extra paper on a project or a proposal that you're using. One way you can do is reuse the paper on the back page. Use it as a note. Might as well you print double page, or if you pay more attention, you print exactly the page that you want to print extra. The other thing you can do is, sometimes you have a lot of extra clothing. You don't wait until it come out, holes comes up, and then you throw away. You can donate to those who need it. Once trash can be once treasure. For example, what Maxwell mentioned, Suji, they need a lot of clothing, blanket, to help the poor or the needs. So you can do something. This is a simple thing that you can do in order to make the world cleaner. The last one is recycle. Sounds easy, isn't it? All you need to do in your trash, you just separate the plastic or aluminium or bottles on the side. Sometimes you feel embarrassed. I only have two cans of aluminium cans, and I don't want to bring the recycling center. I only get 10 cents. Embarrassed. What you can do is, I'm not sure whether you notice, sometimes in the parks, you see some older uncle auntie, they dig through the trash to find aluminium cans, bottles, or glass. What you can do, you can give to them. You kill two birds using one stone. You can help to make your world greener, and then you can help the uncle auntie to make some money. Or you can, again, you can donate to us some charity center. Maybe give it to her mom. You can do. So all this thing are tiny little things you can change, which you've been doing in your daily life. Just a little thing only. No big effort. So you can help us make the world greener. Last. Reduce, reuse, recycle is something that we have to do. It's our responsibility. It's our responsibility to make the world greener, or else we won't. The earth won't last through 2050. Will you join me today to jumpstart the 3 hours within our body to make the world greener?
Tomorrow.
Yeah. Tomorrow. Yeah. Thank you. Back to you, TMT.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jack Ng, for giving such a good call to save the environment.